Morning students, I hope everybody is safe at home. So in the previous class we discussed about the classification made by various scientists. So means you discussed about the Carolus, Linnaeus, Whittaker and Copperland. So these are the scientists. So they, according to their knowledge, so they divided the living kingdom into various different types of groups. So today we discuss about the Whittaker's classification. So Whittaker divided the living world into five kingdoms. So in 1969. So according to him, it means he has given more importance to the presence and absence of the nucleus. So if the nucleus is present, already you know that they are called as the eukaryotes. The cell with the nucleus is called as the eukaryotic cell, and the cell without nucleus is called as the prokaryotic cell. So here he classified the living kingdom into living world into five kingdoms. What are they? The first one is called as Monera. The first one is called as the Monera. The second one is Protista. Third one is Fungi. And fourth one, Plantae. And the fifth one is Amoeba. So in this way, Whittaker divided the entire living organisms into five kingdoms. So first we will discuss about what are the characteristics of Monera. What are the characteristic features of the Monera? So mostly Monera are prokaryotes. Means they are only unicellular organisms. So the Monera, they are unicellular. Only they contain only one cell. And cells have no membrane bonded nucleus. So nucleus is totally absent in the Monera. In the Monera, they are unicellular and prokaryotic. So you know that what is prokaryotic? The nuclear membrane. Nucleus is totally absent. When the nucleus is absent, the other cell organelles are also absent. So it contains only cell membrane, cytoplasm, genetic material, DNA or RNA, and ribosomes. So these are present in the monoliths. The cells, they contain these structures. Then reproduce by splitting into two. So these monoliths, they reproduce through binary fission. Binary fission. Splitting means called as fission. So it may be binary fission or it may be multiple fission. So they use the fission process to reproduce. Then absorb nutrients from outside their bodies. So what they will do? Anyhow, all the cell organelles are absent, so they absorb the nutrients from the outside. From the outside environment, they will get their food. And they move with the help of locomotor organs like flagella, cilia or hair-like structures present on them. So how they will move? Locomotion means movement. So they move from one place to other place with the help of the flagella, cilia. Cilia means the hair-like structures. The example, locomotion. But locomotion will not come under Monera. Okay? The Monera, you can see the bacteria. The bacteria. So in bacteria, nucleus is absent, and if they have the flagella, so with the help of the flagella, it moves from one place to the other place. So this is genetic material, and it contains the carbohydrate, thick cell wall. And some monoliths cause diseases, but others are helpful to people. So few monoliths, they cause diseases, and few are helpful for the people. Already we discussed in the 8th class. Then examples came mostly bacteria and nostoc. Nostoc belongs to the nostoc. This is the genetic structure of nostoc. So this nostoc, it increases the soil fertility. It increases the soil fertility. And bacteria, you know that. So we use uses of bacteria, especially curd is formed, antibiotics are formed. Curd is formed, and also this bacteria, they grow the soil fertility. Okay, this is about the minerals. What are the minerals? They are unicellular, they are prokaryotic, they are produced by binary fission or multiple fission, and they move one place to other place to the flagella cilia, or what they have, flagella cilia or airless structures present on their bodies. And so sometimes they are useful if you are useful, and if you are harmful. Then we discuss about the these three major groups of organisms come under this group. They are archaeobacteria. So this, if you see, this monera again divided into three groups. This bacteria, mostly bacteria comes under minerals. So this bacteria, this is divided into three groups. Minerals, they are divided into three groups. So the first one is Archaeobacteria. Ancient bacteria present till the date. So this is the first group, the ancient bacteria, the first bacteria which is formed on the earth. So some special formed in the hot springs come under this. So few back hot springs means they can able to survive in the hot water also, even 80 degrees centigrade, 100 degrees centigrade also they can able to survive. So the other one is called as Eubacteria. The second one is called as Eubacteria. The second group is called as the Eubacteria. So these are Streptococcus, Rhizobium, etc. and Cyanobacteria, which are also called as blue-green bacteria. So this bacteria also called as what? Blue-green bacteria. Rhizobium, Leguminosarum, we already discussed in the 8th class. So another one, externally but internally are more bacteria, but they are not bacteria. So other are, they are looking like bacteria, but they are not bacteria. So how many are there? You see, there are three major groups of organisms. So what are they? Archaeobacteria, and the second one is the Eubacteria, and the third one is Cyanobacteria. In this way, the monera is divided into three groups. So Cyanobacteria is also called as blue-green algae. It is called as blue-green. Blue-green bacteria. So then you come to the next one, is called as Protista. The second group, kingdom, is called as Protista. So when you come to Protista, the mixed organisms are unicellular. They are unicellular and they are eukaryotic. They contain nucleus. So if you see these aesthetic features of the Protista, most are one cell unicellular, but some are many cells. Means mostly they are unicellular, only few of them they are multicellular, means they contain more than one cell. They are called as multicellular. And cells have a membranous around the nucleus, means they contain eukaryotic. The cells are eukaryotic, means nucleus and all the other cell organelles also present. Then some get nutrients and energy by eating other organisms. So they depend upon the other organisms for their food. So they are called as heterotrophs. So they cannot prepare their own food, so they depend upon the other organisms for their food. And some get energy from the sun. So some of them, they can prepare their own food. So Protista, who are there, they depend upon the other organisms. They are called as the heterotrophs, or you may call as parasites. But few are, they can prepare their own food. How they prepare? With the help of the solar energy, with the help of the sun, and nutrients from the water around them. So these three either solitary or in the colony. So they may live in single, they may live in single, or they may form the colonies. They may form the colonies. So some of the cerambrids are present inside the cell, mostly produced by the splitting into two. Binary fission, like that, how the mother they reproduce, like the protista also reproduce. They also form the, it form two organisms by the process called as binary fission or the multiple fission also there. Then more examples are paramecium, amoeba, algae. Example is paramecium. This is the structure of the paramecium, amoeba, and chlamydomonas. This protista is divided into two groups. That is, that means chlorophyta. Chlorophyta means they can prepare their own food. Example, chlamydomonas. So in the next class, we discuss about the fungi and plant.